Some athletes don't have to utter a single word. Other athletes don't have to rely on cheesy catchphrases and that thing called charisma. Today's case is certainly the epitome of that, as one of the most intense, badass, and influential men ever to step in a wrestling ring, we're taking a look in honoring the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman. Before officially entering the business, breaking in Calgary in 1986, Steve Blackman actually was a competitive bodybuilder and weightlifter before entering pro wrestling. Most people assume Steve Blackman never debuted in the WWF until 1997 at the Survivor Series. However, that is false. Steve Blackman was featured in many enhancement matches in 1988 through 1989 and even scored a pinfall victory over former honoree on this show, Iron Mike Sharp. Unfortunately, during a tour of South Africa while wrestling, Blackman contracted malaria and dysentery of all things, Oregon Trail style, which sidetracked him for a good year and almost made him retire from the business completely in 89. This officially pulled Blackman from in-ring competition at the time, and in total took an insane 6 years of physical therapy for Blackman to recover from all of the muscle mass he had lost and to regain all of his strength. After recovering completely, he started to incorporate martial arts training and taekwondo into his physical therapy. Once back in fighting shape, Blackman then contracted his friends from Canada, Brian Pillman and Owen Hart, for a new WWF tryout. Blackman's debut kind of came out of left field, wasn't hyped, no vignettes. He was simply placed as a quote fan during a Hart Foundation angle with Vader during episode of Raw is War. Blackman was seating in the crowd and jumped the guardrail to help Vader and assist the Harts. A month later, Steve Blackman was in Team USA's corner at the Survivor Series against Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the British Bulldog, Infernus, and LaFont. They lost, but an impressive showing for a debut. With a certain charm and charisma not seen since the likes of Dusty Rhodes, Steve Blackman literally jumped off the screen, demanded your attention, captivated audiences with every word. He didn't really have a prominent feud up until about 99. He would just feud with the Nation of Domination and Jeff Jarrett in between then, but finally made his way into Ken Shamrock's angles, and that was his real first major feud, setting up a Lion's Den match at SummerSlam 99. It wasn't bad. Steve Blackman, without a doubt, two most successful runs in the WWF were his famous team with Al Snow, Head Cheese, and his match at SummerSlam 2000 against Shane McMahon, which to this day might have one of the most breathtaking falls ever by a performer when Shane fell from the top of the stage. A couple of hardcore title runs and somehow slipping through the cracks an entire year during the invasion angle, Blackman was finally released in October 2002, and it wasn't a bad run. For somebody with no real background in pro wrestling and honestly, no charisma, Blackman pretty much exceeded expectations as just jobber cannon fodder. So the next time you're watching the modern era and you complain that guys show no intensity, where have all the real men gone? All you gotta do is simply fire up anything from the Attitude Era and look at the realest man of them all, the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman.